huge tidal current, so if you have navigational aids were in place, that's why it's quite a few lighthouses and lights and things around. Also, if you look up on top of the hill there, you can see a concrete building right on top of the hill. That was a big gun emplacement built by the American military during the Second World War. It had a big revolving cannon on the top of it for shooting enemy ships that might try and get into Wellington Harbour. So if you're ever out this way, it's well worth a bit of a poke around in the bunkers and things like that. It's quite interesting. And also, if you look down in the middle of the valley here, you can see where the river comes through the middle, and there's a half-round grassy paddock on the other side of the river there. Back in 1960, that was the proposed site to build a nuclear power station. If New Zealand got a nuclear power station, that's where it's going to be. It's in the centre of the country, which is good for the distribution of the power, and it's got the river there for keeping it cool. But it's right on the fault line, but they reckon it probably would have been fine. But it worries for nuclear power station. We didn't get it, so. And also, what we're on here is a runway. So back when I was a little kid, about this big, all the hills from here right back to where we started, including all those hills over there, was all grass. And it was farmed a lot more intensively. They had a pretty regular fertilising program. And to put fertiliser on these steep hills, they'd bring planes in here, land them on the runway. There's a shed up the top there where they'd keep the fertiliser. And they'd load the planes up with fertiliser, and they would literally load them up so heavy they couldn't lift off the ground. And they'd come barreling down the runway here, straight out over the edge, straight out over the cliff. As they went over the cliff, they'd dive down into the valley. And as they dived down into the valley, they'd get enough airspeed up to be able to start flying. Just missed that low spot on the hill there, circle out over the ocean, go and dump all the fertiliser off. That took about 2.5 minutes. Then they were landing again. Oh, that was sweet, put a couple more in. Had a short life expectancy, fertiliser pilots, for some reason. But obviously, this is the runway. It was obviously a bit more graded and even and that sort of thing back then. But had a bit of pigs and cattle on it. I believe that all this was put in, a lot of these tracks were put in after the Second World War, because America was pretty intent on defending New Zealand right from well before the Second World War. So they were here not before they were too involved in the Second World War building defences. But sort of after the Second World War, there was all these American troops and all this machinery with nothing to do. And there was no money really anywhere in the world except for the farmers in New Zealand and Australia who were doing quite well. So I guess they had some money, and these guys had all this labour and lots of machines, so they got the tracks in and things like that. So, yeah. Yep. Swap roasted lamb for chocolate and things like that. Yeah. But let's go, eh?